Hey guys, this is David Kwan here. This is my fourth video in continuing to talk about America and gun violence. I think this video is where things will start to get heated, and this is probably the kind of things that people expected me to talk about. Before I get into that, I guess what I want to say beforehand is, you know, there is this issue of gun violence in America. It's ridiculous. In 2011, there has been close to 32,000 gun-related deaths in America, about 11,000 of them homicides, and 20,000 of them being suicides. So the most debated question when we come to that, of course, is not why is America number one, or how did we get there, but of course, the question, how the hell do we solve this? In my view, solving this issue actually goes beyond guns, ironically enough. I think, as I mentioned in my second video, the culture, the media has so much to do with it that I think if we start impacting that, that will actually have more dramatic impact than having different gun laws that are going to try to, you know, regulate gun circulation or gun supply. There's so many other ways to tackle this issue rather than tackling guns. Tackling guns in general is kind of terrifying to me just because that this country is very attached to its guns. So people who are for gun rights and don't want anything to violate their right to own the guns, which is fundamentally protected in the Constitution, the Second Amendment, to right to bear arms. Because the sentiment is so strong, once, if ever it happens, you know, that these gun laws start being implemented, it's possible that, you know, these people who own their guns and have fiercely loyal belief about gun ownership rights, they will fight back, and that's pretty terrifying. There will be a lot of bloodshed if that scenario plays out. So that's why it's to me terrifying to think about imposing really draconian gun laws. And there's a whole philosophical aspect to it: is who decides which gun laws are sensible? And you know, because there's so much differing opinions on what is sensible and what is not. So I actually think to tackle this issue, it should be done more on to tackle the issue of the gun culture as a whole, and to tackle other social issues that are tied to gun violence, such as poverty, unemployment, education, incarceration, and social injustice issues. That's kind of my viewpoint on this thing. But at the same time, it is important to talk about gun laws. Regarding gun laws, one thing that I really want to say is it has to be, if we want to have any gun laws that would actually make big impact on this gun violence issue, it has to be federal. It has to be across the nation. That's because, and conservatives bring up really great points when they start talking about examples of states or cities with ridiculous gun control laws. I live in New York City. New York City is infamous for its draconian gun laws. It's actually becoming much more stricter now, recently. And liberals like to, you know, put New York City on the pedestal because, hey, look, this is a city with ridiculously strict gun control laws. And look at our gun violence rate, which is pretty damn low compared to other cities or states. So liberals like to bring that up. But then conservatives will counter that. Well, they have a lot of counters. With the point that, well, look at cities like Chicago. Look at cities like Los Angeles, Detroit. You know, all these cities with ridiculous gun control laws. Look at their gun violence rate. Look at their crime rate. Look at their, you know, just look at that. It's still super high. So what are these laws doing in those cities? Practically nothing. It's a really great point. And the main reason why I think that's the case is because gun control laws in America are done by city by city, state by state basis. So in a place like New York City, it's surrounded by other cities and other states that have pretty strict gun control laws. Although, I mean, Pennsylvania, I don't think it's that strict as a neighbor to New York State, but I mean, it still has some semblance of gun control legislation. Whereas Chicago, as in Illinois, is surrounded by so many, like Nevada, Utah, or Idaho or Iowa, I don't even know the geographics right now, but it's surrounded by states where gun control laws don't even really exist. So somebody in Chicago can freely go up, like drive up 30 minutes to a different city, easily obtain a gun, and come back, which really disadvantages people who are obeying the gun control laws in Chicago. So that's why I believe if we're to have any legislation regarding guns, that would make a really big impact. And conservatives will hate this idea. It has to be federal. Creating a federal gun control law right now in this political climate is just unimaginable. In fact, doing that might be what incites a civil war. When we have federal gun laws, what should they be? And that's the tricky question, because there's a lot of different ideas here that both sides, like especially the liberals, wants to come up with different proposals to regulate guns and stuff. And some I think are good. So these are my personal opinions, and I don't know, I'm not an expert or anything, so these are just my opinions here and stuff. Background checks and stuff, I think, actually makes sense. If we have a federal legislation and gun control laws are enforced in that manner, so this is my ideal thinking. People who, have criminal background or a mental illness background or whatever, it should not be as easy for them to obtain guns. And if we have federal legislation, we actually need to enforce these gun control laws. So there should be a harder crackdown, like New York City, which it does, for people who own guns illegally. New York City is really harsh with that. In fact, I think if you have a fake gun and you paint it to look like a real gun, that is a criminal offense that will put you in jail for 3 years in New York City. If we have a system in place where gun control laws are federal, if we have a system in place where enforcement of those laws are pretty damn strict, I think it can work with something like background check. Now, I don't like the idea that obtaining a gun has to be really, really difficult and long, because I do believe gun rights is an important thing in America. It is in the Second Amendment of the Constitution, so the whole idea of like let's make it ridiculously just painful and tedious for people to own guns, like let's lengthen the process of applying for a gun to like 6 months or something or 6 weeks, I think that's ridiculous. If a person is qualified to own a gun, meaning they passed a background check, it's like a dry like they passed like the gun shooting test, which is administered by the local government. If they can kind of just prove that they, can own the gun and use it responsibly, yeah, give them the gun as soon as possible. So the whole issue of concealed carry permits, and I actually think concealed carry is great. Again, as long as the process is there, as long as there is a good, a strict system in place where people need to carry their permits or have their permits in order to conceal carry. Because a lot of the states in America, you can conceal carry without a permit at all, which is, to me, kind of scary. But I also think concealed carry should be allowed. Once you have a permit, you should be able to conceal carry anywhere and everywhere, which includes bars, hospitals, schools. I don't like this idea of gun-free zone, which is a very, so this is where I side with the conservative gun rights people. Gun-free zone, it gives advantage to people who are criminals and not the law-abiding citizens. Also, a lot of different talks, debate to be had in regards to bullets. Some people say we should have something like sin tax on bullets or make the price of bullets really high so that people who are really serious and or I don't know. That's a tricky thing to me because I don't want. At the same time, it makes sense in that people who are only really serious about using their guns or really well trained or need their guns will have, will take the time and the money needed to purchase those bullets or whatever. But at the same time, it that really curb that really violates the right to own a gun. Or to use a gun and when you need it to protect yourself. What I do think is interesting, though, I do think bullets as a whole should be sold only by like licensed stores or manufacturers. Being able to buy bullets in a Walmart, for example, is kind of that irks me in a way. They're really cheap. That is a good point that liberals make. They are super cheap. But should they become expensive? I don't know if that's something that we should, you know, that should go for. A bullet registry would actually be a pretty, I don't know. I think that's actually a pretty good idea, in a way, because we right now we have a system where if there is a gun related homicide or something, the forensics team has to, you know, go to the lab and pretty much test out the gun in order to actually figure out what kind of like bullet it is or where the gun came from or where the gun was sold. There is no national registry. There's no even state registry for guns and bullets. I feel like that would really help in like criminal investigations. I know that scares gun rights people because, you know, they just feel that it's something that should be able to freely buy and sell as a normal product. But I think registering a gun, in a lot of ways, it makes sense. We register different kinds of products, such as cars, which is because of insurance liability, different things like that. There are things that we register, you know, we put into the nation's registry. I understand there is this paranoia of big government watching us and like, oh my gosh, this person has a gun. And this, there is like whole paranoia. I know people who own guns, or people who are for, you know, strongly, fiercely for gun rights, they tend to have this view that government is kind of out to get them, and they have this, they need to own their guns in order to fight back in whatever, if a case breaks out where they need to do that. I understand that, but at the same time, it is a public safety issue, and so in order to just for like criminal investigations and public health investigations to occur more stream, like in a more effective manner, I do think a registry having that, because we don't right now in this country, whereas so many other countries in the developed world do, we don't, and I think it's time to start thinking that we should. That's probably the easiest thing to do in this current political climate. Things like having a national, a federal gun control enforcement in this political climate is, I think, highly improbable. The debate is not even coming up on that. But something like gun registration, I think, at least in this stage, is something that could be kind of debated for and argued for. Obviously, I don't have a strong stance on a lot of things in this issue. I am swayed a lot by what I read in this issue. I am a very kind of evidence-driven guy, so I am not on one side or the other, on the extremes. I'm kind of in the middle thinking like, yeah, oh my gosh, the gun rights people here make really great points here. And like, oh yeah, what the gun control people are proposing here seems like a good idea. And then, you know, there's kind of a back and forth overall discussion I'm seeing outside the political landscape that I think are great to see and to have. This is one issue where there is a lot of middle ground, but we're not seeing that in the political landscape, which is interesting. My opinion, to sum it up, is that if we are to have any meaningful gun legislation, it has to be federal, doing it by state-by-state or city-by-state basis, disadvantages law-abiding citizens. And many other ideas, for example, concealed carry, I am with the conservatives on this. I think once you have it, you should be able to conceal carry anywhere, everywhere. You should be highly trained, of course. Your concealed carry permit should expire every few years and you need to get it renewed and have to be retested. So there should be a rigorous process for that. But once you obtain it, that should be like, okay, you're a qualified concealed carry permit owner. You can use your gun anywhere, everywhere, including bars or schools. So this idea of gun-free zones is something I'm personally totally against. If any of you liberal viewer out there is in favor of gun-free zones and would like to argue for it, please do, because I would like to know why you believe gun-free zones make sense, because personally to me, it doesn't. So yeah, that's just pretty much my whole thing on just the gun. It's, yeah, this, I like I said, this video was probably the one, you know, loaded video that people were expecting when I was when I started talking about this topic. I believe I'm going to make one more video on this topic, and that's just to talk about, like, things not about guns, but still related to this issue. So how do we solve this problem? But we don't necessarily have to tackle guns itself. Guns has been the primary focus in this debate, and maybe that's not the wisest thing to do.